Allergic to dogs? How about a robot dog?
That's just one example of the next level technology that's taking off in the Twin Cities. Kaya Edwards shows us more and how it all aims to make life easier, safer, and even more enjoyable.
Dog, meet robot dog.
For this particular one, it's just a really fun toy. More of the consumer level, kind of show off to your friends that you got a nifty cool dog.
The Unitree Go One can roll over, follow humans, climb stairs, and unlike most pets.
Okay, get it.
Dance.
Got some good hips.
How much do these dogs cost?
So this consumer level is more about the 4,500 range.
With cameras for eyes, these fur-free pups are manufactured in China and sold here at Maverick Drone Systems. As their name suggests, they also sell drones.
One, two, three.
Big drones.
It is a big drone, yes.
Making work more efficient for farmers like Jay Sorg, who also works at Maverick.
I grew up on a dairy farm in Hastings, Minnesota, and I still farm with my dad, corn and soybeans. So say we get an inch of rain and you want to apply fungicide to go out there with a wheeled machine, you don't want to be out in that field when it's wet. So with this drone, you don't have to be in the field, you're above the field.
Sorg says they can also save farmers money.
You're doing this yourself versus paying a helicopter or plane to do your aerial application. This machine pays for itself after you applicate 4,000 acres of fungicide. We've had quite a few customers, they buy one and they do their own, and then all of a sudden they're doing their neighbors, and so it's an opportunity for them to branch out and offer their services.
These agricultural drones are in high demand. In fact, this shipment just arrived, bringing in 40 boxes of the latest model.
These weigh about 60, 75 pounds with the battery in them empty, and then their max takeoff weight is 190 pounds. The FAA treat you just like a crop duster because you are technically an aircraft in the air.
In addition to farmers, first responders are customers, purchasing tactical drones like this one.
Pretty much all the metro is using, and now St. Paul Police just came on board.
Tony Caspers is the company's new public safety director.
I've been in law enforcement, retired just recently with 32 years, and I served in the Minneapolis Police Department. The biggest thing with the drones is de-escalation, right? Instead of putting a police officer that's armed in front of somebody that's, you know, having a really bad day, they can come in with the drone. The other thing on this is also just efficiency of our job. So you can take this out, you can actually map a crime scene down to the centimeter. So we're no longer running tape measures and spending hours on a scene. We can take this out on a car crash. We can map and 3D map and print the whole car crash within 5 minutes instead of closing a freeway down for hours.
Turns out our robotic dog isn't all play.
It ranges from entry level all the way up to tactical.
The tactical version can scan buildings like schools and memorize layouts, creating a ready-to-go map that could be used during emergencies.
That's going to be more inside in controlled environments where you can't maybe fly.
In what situations would a robot dog be more useful than the canine?
You just set the dog up and let it monitor something in a hallway. So now you have a camera sitting in a hallway and you can move it as you need to.
Not as cute though.
Not as cute. Yeah. But you don't have to feed it or clean up after it.
From Savage, Kaya Edwards, Carol Evan News.
Well, you can get similar robotic dogs at tech stores like Best Buy, but usually just the commercial versions, not the tactical ones.
So fascinating, so creepy.
Yeah, all at the same time. Exactly.
If I came around the hallway, yeah. It saw that thing looking at me.
Yeah.
I'd rather see the German Shepherd.
But
thank
those
you very much.
Drones for the farmers, that's just genius.
Fascinating
that's
stuff.
Wonderful.